Hey guys, I want to show you a really useful trick with one of the Mayhem mode modifiers. It's the easy one called Lootsplosion. What I'm going to show you is how to make this modifier extremely effective. It's probably the most useful way to use it. It has a bit of a hidden ability, and I'll show you where it works really well. So if you go to the Handsome Jack DLC and then go to the map, the Compactor, the location on the map that you want to go to is this cave that is going to be full of these mini scrap traps. And then there's going to be a main boss called Scrap Trap Prime. When you drop down into this cave, you're going to have the main boss, and then you're going to have these janky scrap traps. And these guys are going to spawn in, and you'll get about like 10 to 15 of them. It seemed like quite a bit. There might even be more. And normally, you cannot get any kind of drops out of these scrap traps other than just ammo. So you're not going to get any weapons or grenades or shields or anything like that. But if you turn on Mayhem and put the easy loot explosion on, then yes, these things drop legendaries, blues, and purples like crazy. And this works really well on Mayhem 10 because these janky scrap traps are extremely easy to kill. I'm using a flat crit build with a flipper that I got from DLC 3, and I pretty much just mow everything down. And the loot explosion modifier says killing an enemy has a 10% chance to cause a loot explosion. Critical hits guarantee an enemy will loot explode. So with my build going in doing mostly critical hits, yeah, it's causing most of the scrap traps to drop loot like crazy. And there's also another awesome trick to make this even better. You can spawn in these scrap traps over and over again without restarting the game, and you don't have to deal with the main boss, the Scrap Trap Prime. You can just ignore him. So once you've killed all these small janky scrap traps, you're just going to have the Prime left, and you'll see the bar up at the top. You won't see the nest bar anymore, and all you have to do is walk up and walk out of this container and make sure not to drop down. You just want to walk out until you're completely cleared of this container. You can see the ledge right there. Just stay right here and then walk back in, and the scrap trap nest will respawn. You don't have to stand out here for any amount of time. Just make sure you clear that container completely. And massive shout out to Dwight. He messaged me about this. He figured out this method, and I really appreciate him reaching out. If you guys have any cool tricks or anything you want me to share with the community, I will definitely shout you guys out. And if you have YouTubes or whatever, I'll definitely help to support you guys. You can always email me glitchingqueen@gmail.com. But yeah, you can spawn in these scrap traps as much as you want. I'm really surprised they haven't fixed this yet, but I'm glad they haven't. Last thing I want to mention before I go is about this weapon that I'm using. This thing is hilarious, and the flipper is one of my favorite weapons, and this thing's from DLC 3. I asked my friend Evil Jug if he could do some cool stuff to it because he likes to handcraft weapons. So he turned this thing into a real flipper. I'll show you what I'm talking about. So here's what a regular flipper looks like, just stock and nothing done to it. And then I'll show you guys what it looks like after. So he took the skin from the ion laser, and there's a reason for that, and I'll explain it in a moment. Then he took the spatulas from the Emperor's condiment, and then he took these grips from the tsunami, and then finally took some parts from the Kibbs Worth. And now the flipper looks like this, and this is something I personally requested because, again, I love this gun, and he added like a breakfast theme to it, so you've got like the egg color with the spatulas, and now this really does have a meaning of being a flipper. It still performs the same. It still has the toggle elementals and does everything it's normally supposed to do. But now you have the animated spatulas on the end and then the egg color, which I think is hilarious. I believe tomorrow he's going to be posting a video and giving away a handful of weapons. I think this is going to be one of them. He also handcrafted and did some cool stuff to the gargoyle and also the unkempt herald. If you guys want to get in on that giveaway, then definitely check out his channel and check out his video tomorrow. I'll have his YouTube link down in the description. But I appreciate him amusing me with these fun little builds. And I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we'll see you next video.